Hello students, today's topic is enzymes. As I have uploaded my previous video, Digestion in Human Beings, you have asked many questions about enzymes. So I am here with the topic enzymes to give you a brief explanation of this. Enzymes are biocatalyst. In one word questions, if enzymes, meaning of enzymes are asked, you have to write enzymes are biocatalyst. Their name has been written by with the suffix "-ase", except few such as trypsin or pepsin, they are not having "-ase" in the suffix. Now, one more point, their enzymes are secreted by exocrine glands present in our digestive system, such as salivary glands and pancreas, gastric glands, intestinal glands, they are secreting different juices. Enzymes help to break down the complex material into simpler material or substances, we can say, so that digestion takes place. Enzymes are present in different digestive juices. Yes, now with the help of this table, I want to explain you different digestive enzymes secreted by different digestive juices which are secreted by our alimentary canal. There are different components of food such as carbohydrate, proteins and fats, and how these food on these food substances, how the enzymes are going to act, we are going to study with the help of this table. As saliva has salivary amylase, which is an enzyme, or it is also called as ptyalin. It works at a specific pH, which is called as 6.8 pH, which is slightly acidic. You can write here, slightly acidic medium it provides. For its action, this type of pH is required. In this, starch, which is a kind of polysaccharide, converted into sugar or maltose, which is a disaccharide. Now, gastric juices are secreted by stomach. In this, there is no enzyme for the digestion of carbohydrate. Now, when food moves forward, there are pancreatic juices which act upon it. Pancreatic juices are having one enzyme called as pancreatic amylase, which act in alkaline or basic medium. Pancreatic amylase act upon the remaining carbohydrate which is left undigested in the mouth, and this remaining carbohydrate converted into disaccharides or partially digested carbohydrates. By the help of pancreatic amylase, this reaction takes place. Now, when food moves forward, then intestinal juices are there which secrete intestinal amylase enzyme required for the digestion of carbohydrate. As carbohydrate which are partially digested in the by the help of pancreas, maybe they are disaccharides, with the help of intestinal amylase converted finally into glucose, which is a monomer or monosaccharide. So, this is the procedure how carbohydrate digested finally started from the saliva and ended in the final digestion takes place in intestine. Now, protein component of the food, digestion of it we will see with the flowchart. In mouth, secrete saliva. Saliva has no enzyme for the digestion of proteins. Now, when food moves into the stomach, secretes gastric juices. Gastric juices secrete an enzyme called pepsin, which works in slightly acidic medium, that is pH is about 1.8 to 2 pH is required, which is you can write it as acidic medium is required for the action of pepsin, which is maintained due to the secretion of HCl. Pepsin will convert proteins into proteases and peptones, right? Now, when food moves forward, pancreatic juices also secrete one of the enzymes required for the action of protein digestion, that is trypsin. Trypsin work in alkaline or basic medium. As I have told you earlier also, pancreatic amylase is also work in the alkaline or basic medium. Trypsin is also working in the alkaline or basic medium. That means pancreatic juices are working in basic medium. This trypsin convert the leftover proteins plus proteases and peptones which are formed in the stomach into dipeptides, or according to the NCERT, you can just write partially digested proteins. Then, when protein move forward in the intestine, intestine secretes intestinal proteases enzymes, or you can just write intestinal enzymes according to the NCERT. Partially digested proteins or dipeptides, which are left by the trypsin, they are converted finally into the monomers called amino acids. These are the monomer of proteins or building blocks of the protein. That means final digestion takes place again with the help of intestinal enzymes. Now move forward for the next component of the food, that is fat. Saliva has no enzyme, that means no digestion of fat takes place in mouth. Now when food moves forward in the stomach, there is no enzyme in the gastric juices which help to digest the fat. Now when food moves into the duodenum, there are pancreatic lipase secreted. Pancreatic lipase is there for the digestion of fat. Fat converted into partially digestion of fat takes place here. Next, with the help of intestinal lipase again. Lipase is the word you can, now you can understood that lipase is the enzyme for the digestion of lipids. Intestinal lipase enzyme is there which digests these partially digested fat into its monomer, that is fatty acids and glycerol. These are also called as monomer or building block of fat. I hope that I tried at my level best to make you understand about different enzymes which are present in different digestive juices. And with the help of this table, which is very brief to make your notes, please note down each and every point of the video and keep update yourself for the next video. Keep learning and be